And we're live.
We drove some go. When did we do go-karts? Yesterday? We went to this go-kart place called Unser Racing. If anyone wants to look it up and like see what this place is, it's UNSER. This isn't a plug or anything. But we went to this place called Unser Racing and did some go-kart racing. And it was so extreme. It was, I think it was $60 for three races. It was so extreme that my girlfriend got knocked out not unconscious, but she was knocked out of the racing.
She was knocked after silly. The first. Yeah.
She got hit and it like jostled her. And so she had a terrible headache. But then I think she said the combination of the fumes, because they're gasoline indoor, and the tight turns was making her dizzy. So she's like ready to throw up, and like she checked the fuck out. They refunded her ticket price. But the rest of us, those were the fastest go-karts I've ever been on. I've never been on go-karts that fast.
I didn't think it was gonna be that fun going into it, because I'd only ridden go-karts that you see like next to the bumper boats pool and adjacent to the mini golf, and I kind of pictured it like that. And these like immediately accelerating, like my modus operandi in go-karts is, what's a break? Why do I need a break? This thing's not going to go fast enough that I could get hurt. It's inconceivable. And so like the first real lap, I was playing by those rules and these gas carts, to the point that I was like going so fast around a corner. I was like, are other people doing this? Like, there's no way. Like, this is fucking scary. Like, I'm like skipping out to the side as the wheels stutter. I hit Chiz so fucking hard in the side of his car. It was totally an accident, but I thought he was going to jump out and want to fist fight me, because he was taking a turn and I was taking a turn, and I've been following him. I was tracking my prey, and I was like, Chiz tends to take big sweeping kind of Tokyo drifting turns, and I was like, I bet I can get right tight in around that corner and whip it real quick, get away from him and take the lead. And so I tried that, and Chiz must have noticed me, because at the last second he cut his turn sharper and I completely T-boned him going whatever speed those go if you haven't touched the brake in 40. a solid minute. And I hit him so hard that his whole thing tipped up and then came back down, and I ran into my belt so hard that my collarbone area is bruised. I it was so hard. And he looked over at me, and I could only see through his eyes like this amount, just the fury that he had, that he felt at me in that moment, of was like, I fucking hate you. I wish you were dead. I wish you broke your neck in this collision. Like, he was so mad, but he took it well in the end. It was a blast.
We did the same thing for like the Woody Craft team building thing, and same experience. Mm-hmm. Like, immediately you recognize, like, holy smokes, these are dangerous. I had no idea there'd be any danger involved. You know, I thought you could just lay on the gas the whole way. Worst case scenario is you just sort of gently slide into a wall. No. Like, there were people not in our group, not that work for me, but in another group, because like we'd go and then they'd go and we'd alternate. Guy flipped upside down, landed on his head in like the tires, that because there'd be like the track is defined. And then in between the curves were just all these like old tires. He's upside down, hanging from his 5-point harness with his head in a tire. Like, the fuck? You know? Like,
and, get it out!
Yeah, he hit the side of the wall and, like, launched terrible. Into the... Yeah, like...
Did they refund his money? Because if I didn't get, like, a token or something, I'd be pretty upset. Because they did.
Going.
They gave me some tokens.
Yeah, they got his car. They put it back in. They let go. And yeah, so that's what they did. But I was surprised how dangerous it was. And the other thing was, in our group anyway, it seemed like who did the best had a lot to do with weight. And I don't know if you guys found the same thing. Like, you know, Heather Gamertag.
Not as big of a difference as I would have thought.
She crushed everybody because she weighs like 85 pounds. She has had the hardest time. And the only, like, some of the guys that were close were me. And we had a light guy. He was like 16, but he didn't drive. So he had like not much talent. And whereas I drive every day and I was heavier. So we were close. And, but yeah, so anyway, but it was too weight dependent. That was the one thing I wish
I didn't find that to be the case here. Our times were all fairly similar. I think Taylor had the best average time, maybe, but like it's like the record for all time at that place was like a 29.3 lap, and we were all run. Our best laps were all around 33 seconds. So we were like a full 3 to 4 seconds behind like the track record.
When we were waiting to go on our last run, they were having like a championship run or something where the previous people who had won their little events came out there and they had their racing. And it became apparent, like when you watch them get set up, it's like, oh, woohoo, like championship. I bet this is just like when you take the all-star laser tag squad.
Right.
Like, it's not going to matter. They started out and immediately you could tell whoever this fucking guy was that earned his spot into first place, like he got there for a reason. He must come back every day for championship time.
He's got his own helmet and fireproof suit.
Are these the seven guys today? Are these the seven guys? All right. Nice to meet you guys. Won't see you tomorrow. All right. And then he gets there and it was a boring race to watch because he took so much of a lead. He was lapping people by the end.
When he won, he did a lap with the checkered flag. And he was really proud. He was waving that thing like Richard Petty out there or something. He was loving it. I found it interesting that like the championship thing, like when we race, they like a guy like kicks open a gate and he's like, all right, go, don't go too fast because you need to let the whole field get in and you don't want to crash into anybody, go. And like, they don't care. But with their thing, they did like a NASCAR, like rolling start where everyone was lined up in the middle of the track in a certain formation and they all got going slower and then they got faster and faster. And the flags were confusing to me because I didn't pay attention at all in the class that took place before. All I cued in on was don't hit people because they said it so many times and they threatened you legally so much that I was terrified of hitting someone. And so on my first lap, maybe two laps, I was going like zero contact, like whatever. If it meant I lost a place, you know, so be it, not touching anybody. And then I saw somebody get nailed so goddamn hard that they spun twice and nobody said shit. And then I bumped somebody and it was really advantageous to me. I boxed them out. Yeah. And it even seemed to like I could, you know, you can feel your momentum. It felt like I took a little of their momentum with me. And I was like, I ramped it up lap after lap, the amount of contact that I was comfortable with on that particular racetrack until they were like waving these like warning flags and signs that said no contact and pointing at me. They're like, you no contact. Cause I just gave no shits.
It's because you went from like courteous driver to just totally wacky races, like over the course of like 15 minutes to where you were, you know, running into people in the side, boxing them out. I think we both, and now other people besides us got black flagged. They said the black flag was, so first of all, anyone out there who has a go-kart place and you're making a series of flags that have meanings, you can't have seven different colors of flags and expect us to remember.
So many flags.
That's like, it was in the orientation. She started taking these flags out and was like, this is the white flag. When this is waved, it means that you are, or this is the yellow flag. We'll wave this at the beginning telling you it's a slow lap. When the white one goes, yes, it's seven flags. I wasn't exaggerating. See, and by the end, like the first time they wave a black flag at me, I'm like, oh shit. Like, is that a congratulations? Is that a don't do what you just did? Is that a final lap? I don't know. You know, just keep going and see what happens.
Black flag means stop, right? It got to the point that I saw.
No, black flag means, hey, you watch it. Like, don't bump into people. At one point, Kyle was in front of me and they pointed at him to stop running into people, but they also held the sign that said let people pass, because there was a flag
make
that they
your
would
mind
wave
up asshole
pass, because like apparently they're frowned upon one guy just like mean mugging everybody else just yeah. and so they'd wave the flag pass thing, and Kyle was fucking not having any of it, and it was a little funnier because I was the guy they were waving the flag and I was gonna be like, yeah, Kyle, come on, let me pass. But they waved that and they had to hold two dry erase signs at the same time towards Kyle as they pointed at him, just that said like, don't hit other people and let them pass. And it's just like, you.
I was pushing it as far to the edge and to the limit of what was allowed at that track for maximum fun. I had so much fun. Like there were a couple characters out there who seemed to be driving really aggressively. Now, I was driving aggressive, but mostly on my own. Like the main card I got was stop sliding out. They said it like four times in a row, and I just kept sliding out because I wanted to. Because I'm trying to find the optimum way to take this turn. And so, like, I'm pushing it to the limit of what I think it can do, and it spins out every single time. And, you know, after four spinouts, I found a perfection in the fifth. But I lost my train of thought.
You were having a good time?
Other people were more aggressive. mind that they said
I
not
hit
to spin
people out. Hard. Yeah, there were a couple guys who were actually driving aggressively, and I swear to God, it was the Asian guy. The Asian guy was so bad at fucking driving. He spun out, and all he had to do, Woody, was turn the wheel this much. Like, all right, this is straight. This is like straight ahead. He had to go and push the gas, and his car would have went and left and gotten the fuck out of my way. But I'm screaming at him, turn the wheel and go. Turn the wheel and go. And I'm 6 feet away from this guy. He's like right in front of me. And he's going until someone comes and manually drags him out of my fucking way. And I felt like I was doing well at that point because we're racing for time. We're all trying to beat that tiny little Tanya chick who weighs 120 pounds and is a good driver.
It's the weight. Heather weighed like 85 pounds and she's a good driver, but I felt like she just completely denied that weight played any role in it. Like if you stacked how fast everybody was, you could also stack them by weight and get the same answers.
Yeah.
And Heather was so much lighter and it made such a difference in these little go-karts, but she was like, no, it's cause I'm good. It's cause I'm really good. You're 85 pounds. You're 85 pounds. You know, like I can see all your ribs through your shirt.
Through your skin. You're translucent. So yeah, go-karts were fucking fun. It was a little shame that my girlfriend got just absolutely destroyed and had to like sit there and watch all teary-eyed while we raced because she was so shaken up by the ordeal. But we got her money back, you know, for her races. And she told me that I was like credited like some free races. So maybe if I come back, I get to do that because I really enjoyed that. Those are the coolest go-karts I've ever been on.
You can try those. I mean, you don't live near here, but maybe you can try those tokens at Dave & Buster's.
I don't think that they will work there. I don't think that's how that works.
There's one out in Wildwood. I'm pretty sure that it'll work.
No.
Never mind.